I'll make my way out. That was close. Thanks for bailing me out of a jam. Now, me and Pastor Jerome have been attacking convoys and freeing prisoners for a while now. But this time, everything went sideways. We took out a truck, but got blindsided by some highwaymen. They captured Jerome. I barely managed to get out alive. The Lord knows where they've taken Jerome. There might be a clue in the truck we took down. It's not far from here.
My name's Jerome. I appreciate your help, but we've got more work to do. They were taking me to the old rye house to torture me. They've got other prisoners there. I could use your help to save those people.
Never cared about morals before, since there was nothing to be moral about. Now every day is a freaking dilemma.
Gary. That's a relief. Let me introduce myself properly. Jerome Jeffries. Most folks call me Pastor Jerome. I appreciate what you've done here. You have an instinct for helping folks. That's usually my calling. Mickey and Lou won't stop until they've bled Hope County dry, and they don't care about who they crush in the process. We need people to stand up to them. I'd follow someone like you. If you're looking for an ally, you found one.
I miss ramen. I bet there's ramen in heaven.
I feel sorry those folks had to give up their home. They had their whole lives ahead of them.
I can't understand people like Jerome. Where's the benefit in trying to save people? You gotta work for your own self. That's what Pops taught us.
You're thinking. She's got the body of a 30-year-old, but a face like a scrotum that got left out in the sun. But whether you believe it or not, you're looking at the best shooter in what's left of this miserable planet. You can call me Nana. If you're here looking for a partner to teach those no-good highwaymen a lesson, then I'm interested. Oh, but you don't get my help for free. I set up a shooting range out here to keep my skills sharp. Show me what you're made of. Impress me, and I'll tag along while you teach these masked whippersnappers a thing or two. Fresh air. I'll be tied up in a tree and left for the bears. You're a damn good shot. But I got something for you only I could crack. You climb up that silo and wipe your feet, mind you, and get a better vantage, nice and high. I'll send up some balloons as targets. You wouldn't believe the squeaky wheels I had to grease for the helium gas. Impress me and hit the balloons as they go up. In all the years since the dust went up, I'm the only one that's been able to get them all. No mistake. More than I expected. And when there's too much spark, oh, that's how you get wildfires. How about we try something trickier? After all, balloons and helmets don't shoot back, now do they? Oh, try this one on for size.
Thank you.
That can improvise in a tight spot. Because courses is easy. Targets that don't scurry around are honey cake. Now, moving targets, oh, loud, rude, hyper-violent, disrespectful hooligans, those are some targets. You, boy, you're sharp, quick-witted, and a lightning shot. Quite the combination to have in a respectful young person. I don't see it too often these dusty odd days. Everyone needs someone looking out for them out here. Even me, once in a blue moon. You consider me part of the family. I'll look after you, kiddo. Maybe I'll collect some more highwaymen skins for the quilt I'm making. Oh, you'll never know if I'm kidding.
Fucking sound.
Armstrong. This is great. This is Grace Armstrong. The Highwaymen took my weapon.
Mushroom or ethanol, aerosol, blood, blood.
What was that?
You're that outsider, huh? Yeah, the highwaymen are none too happy with you. Good. About time you young gun stepped up to the plate. Name's Grace. And if I wasn't blind as fuck, I'd be fighting right beside you. I might have lost a step or two, but I'm still putting my hands to good use. Once I realized I couldn't aim and shoot like I used to, I built a gun where none of that would matter. It's inspired by something you cooked up, actually. Only I made a few modifications. If I wasn't so modest, I'd say it was the best gun in Hope County. Only problem is the highwaymen stole it from me and took it to the old train yard. That's where they hoard all the goods they've been stealing from the people here. It won't be easy, but trust me, the risk is worth the reward. Go get the gun, steal back the supplies they took, and mow down any pinheads who get in your way.
Yard, have a look inside the freight cars. That's where the highwaymen stash the shit they've been taking from us. That's where you'll find my gun. forget to grab the materials. We'll need that stuff if we're gonna push back against the Highwaymen. Those saws will cut through just about anything. And whatever they don't cut through, they'll bounce off of. Use metal surfaces to ricochet. That'll help you get the edge on anyone using cover.
We stash the good shit. So make sure you got eyes everywhere. And I'm
perfect against those shielded fuckers, too.
What's making that noise?
Yard. Come see me when you're done.
Thing's pretty sweet to use, isn't it? You did good. Smack those Highwaymen right in their mouths. Keep the gun. Like I said, my eyesight ain't what it used to be. Figure you'll get more use out of it than I will. And those supplies you collected, that stuff belonged to the people. Invest it back into the community. The folks in Prosperity will make the best use out of whatever you can give them, me included. You heard right. I'm headed to Prosperity for good. You and your friends ever need training? You come see me. Take care of yourself.
Oh,
out and take more shit from you people, only this time, we won't be as nice about it.